Algebra is the branch of mathematics that uses letters in place of numbers. We call these letters pronumerals. When we use a letter instead of a number, it might be because that number is going to change, that is, it's a variable. For example, the speed my car is traveling at is changing constantly. So if I wanted to use the pronumeral s to be my car's speed, then that value s is going to change all the time. The other reason we might use a pronumeral is if we don't know a number. For example, I don't currently know how long this video is going to be, but I could represent its duration or the length of time that it runs for as perhaps t, the time that my video runs for. I don't have to use t, even though t stands for time. I could have used x or y. It doesn't matter. So we have our pronumerals, letters instead of a number. If I wanted to do some maths, some arithmetic, some problem solving with these values, even though I didn't yet know them or they were still going to change, I could write an expression. For example, if at the end of this video I know I'm then going to have to go back and add another 5 seconds worth, that would be t, the time that the video takes, plus that extra 5 seconds, t plus 5. What I've written here is an expression. It's just a sum that uses pronumerals and can use numbers as well. In that expression, I've just said t plus 5 happens to equal the amount of time my video will end up taking. If I actually represent that as an equation, t plus 5 equals, and let's say I've looked ahead once I've finished this and discovered that this was 65 seconds long. What I now have is an equation. It's different from an expression because I've added in an equals sign and I know what the expression equals. I can solve that equation. Now this one's really easy. The original time that my video took plus an extra 5 seconds is 65 seconds. Obviously the original time was only 60 seconds. We've just solved that equation. That is, we've found out what our unknown number was. In using algebra, we have algebraic terms. An algebraic term is separated out from another one by plus or a minus sign. So 6xy plus 7x minus 3 has three terms. 6xy, 7x, negative 3. You'll notice that the sign that belongs to the term is the sign that's in front of it. 7x is positive, and over here we have negative 3. If there's no sign in front of the first term, of course, that would mean it was positive. The algebraic term 6xy, as you know, means 6 times x times y. Those times signs join that term together. We don't use multiplication signs in algebra, so if I've got 6 times x times y, I simply write that as 6xy. The other terminology that we need to know here is the coefficient. The coefficient is the number in front of a term. 6 is the coefficient of xy, 7 is the coefficient of x. A constant term doesn't have any pronumerals. It's just a number. So negative 3 is our constant term in this expression. It is, of course, an expression, not an equation. No equals sign. So our terminology that we've learnt today. Our pronumeral is a letter used instead of a number. An expression, or an algebraic expression, is when we've got a sum that uses some pronumerals, possibly some other numbers. An equation is when we take an expression and add an equal sign and the value that that whole expression equals. We can solve an equation to work out what our pronumerals actually had as their value. A term or an algebraic term is a part of the expression that's separated out from other terms by plus and minus signs. And a variable is, of course, when our pronumeral is used because our value might change.